Now, throughout the week, we've been looking at Europe's uneven recovery and what it means for some of the countries in the EU. And one area that's been getting a boost is what's become known as the sharing economy. Millions of people are sharing cars or even homes through apps like Uber and Airbnb. But in the Netherlands, thousands are signing up to a site that allows users to share everyday items like a drill or a ladder. Anna Holligan reports from Amsterdam.
The Netherlands is one of the most densely populated countries in the world. People are used to sharing their space. And the economic crisis made the Dutch more conscious about how they're spending their euros. Instead of buying more material possessions, they're buying into the idea of sharing things. This is the headquarters of Pierby.
It just makes sense to not own things that you only use once or once every month. Came up with the idea for PB in 2009 when my house burned down, and suddenly I didn't have any things. I didn't have a house, and I had to depend on the people around me. I had to ask for help. You know, it really made me want to do something that is about connecting people instead of consuming.
So how does this actually work? We're going to put it to the test. We've just moved in here. We don't have any furniture, but we do have family coming to stay this weekend, and they need somewhere to sleep. So I'm going to see if we can borrow a hammock. Lots of users in my neighbourhood. Enter your request, and 9 people have offered to lend me a hammock. Choose one, open the chat, and arrange collection.
Pierby now has 15,000 registered users in Amsterdam alone. We've come to meet one of them in Vondelpark.
I needed to make coffee for 200 people. Well, that's a lot. And I thought, okay, I can go somewhere and rent it. And then I thought, oh no. So I put it on Pierby, and especially because you put a line with it, why do you need it? And I said, hey, it's for a neighborhood party. And I think within 3 hours, I got this offer of 4 or 5 coffee machines.
This is a system that relies on trust, which is sometimes abused. Some users report that their items haven't been returned. Others say it's used for begging. What's unique about Pierby is that there is no fee. At the moment, the company isn't making any profits. So the question is this a sustainable business model?
No, I think it's definitely here to stay. It's something we can stop because people are now empowered to organize themselves, to arrange things themselves, so they don't need big corporations anymore.
According to Pierby, 80% of the things we have at home we use no more than once a month. An incentive, perhaps, for people to do less buying and more borrowing. Anna Holligan, BBC News in Amsterdam.